All right, so in this video, let's talk about differences between SUMIF, SUMIFS, COUNTIF, and COUNTIFS functions. And we'll start with some obvious differences, and then we'll get into things that are probably not that obvious. So we have this little data set here. So let's go ahead and do a SUMIF function. So that's conditional summing. I'm going to go ahead and sum up all the sales amounts for a particular region. As a range here, that starts with our criteria range. So the criteria range is going to be the list of regions in this column. So I basically need to select from here and all the way down, but I'm just going to select the whole column, make this simple, comma. And then the criteria for this range would be the region I'm trying to get the total for. So if I do something like West, that should be the criteria for this. This is not case sensitive, so I can do lowercase, uppercase. And then finally, we'll do the range for some range. So that will be this D column. Close parentheses, hit enter. And then we should get the total for West region. So basically, we're going to add this, you know, anything that's West in this column. Now that gives us the total for this function. Now, similar to this, we can use SUMIFS to get the same thing done. So to do that, we'll do SUMIFS. And the only difference here is that the order of arguments is gonna be a little different. So here we start with a sum range first. So that's gonna be sales amounts, comma. Then we have criteria range, which is gonna be region, comma. And then finally, I want this to be West. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this. Hit enter, we should get the same amount using SUMIF and using SUMIFS. Now, the obvious difference between these two functions is that with SUMIFS, you can do multiple criteria. So what I could do after I did this first criteria to be West, I can go ahead and do a comma and do another optional criteria range with a criteria. So for example, I could select this column B and I could say from that column, I would like to get Jennifer. And what should happen now? It should get us the total for West Jennifer combination. There is the total. So we can keep adding more by doing another comma and doing another pair of basically criteria range and criteria. Now, if you want to learn about more details about these functions, I have separate videos covering these functions. So there are a lot of interesting things here you could do. You can do wildcards here as a criteria and things like that. But I'm not going to get into it. So before I move on to differences that actually make a difference for these functions for me, I want to just very quickly do COUNTIF and COUNTIFS too. So the difference is going to be pretty much the same. As a matter of fact, if you just take some if function and just copy and paste it and just change it to COUNTIF and just basically get rid of this sum range argument out of here, that should get us the count. So now it's going to give us, basically we have 5 sales in West region. So it's going to count 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5. So that's that. And similar to this, if I take the SUMIFS function, copy it, hit escape, go back here, paste, and switch this SUMIF to COUNTIFS, and then I'm going to remove the sum range out of here, which is the first one in this case. So that should give us how many we have of this combination West Jennifer. Now let's get to less obvious differences. So the biggest difference for me between these functions is that SUMIF, unlike SUMIFS, can actually handle arrays. So let me demonstrate what I mean by that. If I just go ahead and delete this, and let's say we just list a few regions here. Now, if I wanted to get the total for each one of these regions, I could do equals SUMIF, and then I would take the range, which is going to be this criteria range. And in this range, I need it to be south in this line of list, comma, and I need to sum these sales amounts. So if I hit enter, and as you can see, we have this suggested autofill. So that just dragged this formula, see, basically just Google Sheets helping us to drag that formula down. However, this is not going to happen if we just add another region here. So we need to manually go here and drag this down to get the next one over. So let's remove these two. Get back to this first formula. And what I'm going to do right in here where it says F2, I'm going to just convert that to an array. So I'm going to remove that one reference as a criteria. And I'm just going to select something like this. And then I'm going to do Control Shift Enter to add array formula. But that didn't work. Let's try it again. So there it is, array formula around this. So it works as an array formula. I hit Enter. And as you can see, we get this automatic drop down effect. So now we could go here and do something like northeast and get the total for that one. See, it automatically just happens because now it's an array, right? Now, SUMIF can handle arrays. COUNTIF will also handle arrays. So if I just copy this, hit escape and paste it over here and just do COUNTIF. And again, we'll remove the sum range out of here and hit enter. And you can see how it automatically just drops this down, right? However, if I try to do this using SUMIFS or COUNTIFS, it will not work the same way. So if I do the sum range here, comma, then I'm going to do the criteria range, which is this, comma. And then when I get to criteria, again, if I just select one, it's just going to work like it works as usual. However, if I try to do an array similar to this, Control Shift Enter to add my array formula wrapper, I hit enter, that does not work because SUMIFS, COUNTIFS, all of these don't basically handle arrays. Now, the last thing I'm going to do here to remove these zeros, I'm going to go to this range, which is our criteria range from F2 through F7, and I'm going to add a filter to this. So I'm going to put that inside of a filter function, just like that. And as a condition for this filter, I'm going to check if that same range is not equal to blank. And now when I hit enter, you'll see these zeros are gone because we basically just filtered to not use these blanks. And we get our totals. And now if I just go back here and add a new region, that will work. And you could expand this criteria range over here if you want to just keep adding more to this list. Just like that. And again, we could have done the same thing with COUNTIF by simply just taking that same formula here, converting that to COUNTIF. And then just get rid of this sum range out of here and keep everything else exactly the same. That should work the same way. So the last difference I'm going to talk about between SUMIF and SUMIFS is that when you use SUMIF, the sum range is actually optional, this last argument. With SUMIFS, it's mandatory. Let's do a quick example here. If I take this sales amount and I wanted to sum anything above 5,000 in that column, I could simply just say greater than or equal to 5,000. And what this is going to do, it's going to sum anything in this column above 5,000, just like that. Now, technically, you could do a comma and add that D column all over again as the sum range. But since the same column is the sum column and the same column is the condition, you don't have to do the sum range. Now, to do the same thing with SUMIFS, we must select that sum range. So we're going to do this, comma. Then we're going to do criteria range being the same. And then we're going to say it's greater than or equal to 5,000. And that should do it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. And I'll see you in the next one.